And Sisters 7. After the label issues started, she started her own band, the Black Box Rebellion, and performs regularly as a solo act. She's in town for her weekly show at the Mucky Duck. Patrice Pike, welcome back to KPFT. How are you?
I'm great, Rourke. How are you?
I'm good. It's been, what, 10 years since you were last on the program with me?
Yeah, with you. I haven't seen you in a long time.
But you were here not too long ago with Marlo Blue, and you guys did some stuff on the air together.
Yes.
And you've always been great to KPFT, and you usually play our benefit concerts. I think the anniversary party is the one that you normally do for us.
Mm-hmm.
So thanks. Okay. Well, maybe we'll see you again this year in March.
It's possible.
We won't talk about that just yet. But you grew up in Dallas. Tell me a little bit about that. Did you go back home for the holidays?
I was home in Austin where I live for Christmas.
Yes.
And had a big Mexican food feast and invited lots of friends and
Very nice. And you hosted?
Yes.
Okay.
It was awesome. It was normally I go and try to see my grandmother, and she came for Thanksgiving, and this time it was so cool to be able to be at home and for people to just come to me.
Sure.
It's normally, I mean, I travel all the time, and in the holidays it's no exception, so it was great to just sort of have people just show up all day long at different times of day.
Right. And you had a good New Year's in Vegas.
I went to Vegas.
But it was pretty tame.
I don't gamble. I don't know if I'd call it tame, but it wasn't what people normally
tame
do.
Tame for Vegas.
Yeah.
Right.
It just wasn't, I'm not a gambler, so.
Sure.
And someone told me it's not gambling if you don't lose. And then I sent them a text, winning! But no, there was a party a friend of mine had, and it was a really great party, and it was actually an intentional sort of come and have fun, but also get together in the living room after the new year and talk about if you could think of something that would be amazing that you don't have in your life that you want to have in your life, mm-hmm. what would that be? And it was a pretty mm-hmm. interesting subject for everybody.
I bet that lasted all night.
Yeah, it did.
Tell me about Booker T. Washington, the performing visual arts high school you went to. Is it like the movies? Was it like Fame? You know, and there's a lot of new, like, Disney shows about, I think, High School Musical.
Yeah.
Is it like that? Have you seen those?
It actually was kind of like that, and probably more like that then than it is now. Mm-hmm. One of my best friend from high school teaches there now, and she was a ceramics artist, and she always fills me in on how it changes in terms of the politics and the freedom of the students and things mm-hmm. like that. We had an incredible amount of freedom, and people did perform in the hallways, and there was, you know, sudden, you know, acts of, you know, random acts
right.
of art happening all over the place.
Very
so
cool.
It was amazing for me to get a chance to still be in public school where
mm-hmm.
it was not homogenized and a mixture of different people from, you know, different ethnicities and socioeconomic classes, and be able to focus on art and be encouraged by your teachers to do
mm-hmm.
that. And equally, academics were important, but they made our art just as important, which a lot of people don't get to experience, especially now that the deterioration of arts in schools.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And Edie Brickell went there?
Yeah.
And Nora Jones?
Yes.
Anybody else?
Erica Badu?
Uh-huh.
Roy Hargrove?
Wow.
Lots of great people that I actually, Edie's a little older than me, but all of the other people that we just mentioned, like Roy was in my class, and
mm-hmm.
Erica was a year younger, I think.
Very nice. And your stepfather was a musician.
Yeah, he was the guy that I was around, the grown-up that was in live bands, that I sort of learned about what all of that was about,
sure.
good and bad.
Right.
And unfortunately, he was never able to make a full-time living long-term. And that really influenced my decision that I was going to do that come hell or high water.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and did he give you your ukulele? I know that you had a ukulele as a kid. Did it come from
my,
your stepfather?
One of my grandparents gave me a ukulele.
And did you teach yourself how to play? Did you take lessons?
I did. What was funny is that my stepdad had a studio in the backyard,
mm-hmm.
and I always wanted to play with their big guitars.
Right.
And I was really small person, which I still am, but they thought it was cute, and so they got me this blue ukulele. And my mom was telling the story the other day. She said I called it my toodaloo, and I always get totally embarrassed when my mom tells that story in front of my friends, but it's cute. So I played that, and then I played violin.
Right.
I started when I was 3.
Okay, and we'll talk more. We have Patrice Pike live in the KPFT studio doing her weekly thing over at the Mucky Duck. show starts at 6:30 and lasts till about 8:30, and we'll talk more about that in a minute. But what are you going to sing for?